Hello, happy site owners. Mayanna here with the Blog A Tips Tuesday video recap for June 6, 2017. Let's jump right on in because, you know, this week there's some really important news and some of it is not going to hit for a little while. I'll try to keep y'all way ahead of the curve. Sometimes that's 6 months, sometimes that's a year, sometimes that's 2 years ahead of the curve. And, you know, one of the things I know is most people won't make a change until they feel pain. I get that. So smart people listen to me and get that done really quick. I try to jump on things really fast when it happens too, as much as we can, or tell you when to hold off for those things. So I hope you do see the significance in what I'm telling you, that I'm not just wasting your time, because we do need to keep our eye on a few things. And the other thing I'm going to do right quick is get this up, because I'm on Facebook Live right now streaming. If you're watching this on YouTube, be sure to like the Blog A Facebook page so you can catch me live and ask your questions and stuff too. And I'm going to have ways, hopefully soon, I believe I'm testing out some new stuff, for you to come on live with me, not just put in your thing in the chat. So let me scroll down here and make sure that I can see this video, and I cannot. There it is. Okay, I just want to make sure that I can see that. So that I can see your questions and comments and your likes and things that go on with that too. So, okay, I'm going to set that up there where I can see it. Let's jump in to what's going on here this week. My Updraft Plus series of tutorials and posts is coming. As a matter of fact, I just recorded one right before I jumped onto this, you know, and it's like, oh man, I gotta hurry because I gotta get on time at the time that I told people I would be live on here. So I'm thrilled about that. I'm covering how to back up your site with the free version of it, and the files that it doesn't get, and how to get those, right? And then I'll be covering all the features in the premium version that are different, because it does get everything, and how to set all of those up. And then I'll be covering the little migrator plugin, which I just dearly love. I've fallen in love with this thing. Now that one will only be on my webmaster training tutorials in level 2, because it's something for designers and people who maintain sites that need to do that kind of migration and whatever. You also get some of those functions in the premium version as well, but the license for the premium version is locked to a site, so you can't do a bunch of migrating, whatever. You really need the little migrator add-on to do that. And then I've got a post coming that has this versus that, you know, so you can see what all three versions have, get a little checklist of everything, and make up your mind what's best for you to do. So look for those coming. They're coming out all week long. And so I'm really thrilled about that, because Updraft Plus is officially now my recommended backup plugin for small to medium sized sites. If you have a bigger site, you probably still need to be on something like WordPress, Blog Vault, another cloud service. Rule of thumb for that is small site would be something on shared hosting maybe, and then bigger sites would probably be on VPS. So, you know, look for those. Also, ahead of this, because if you're going to back up files, you got to have a place to store them off your site. You don't want to rely on your host, even if you're paying your host to do backup files for you. They are not guaranteed. I've seen so many people burned by that. And they were like, yeah, I paid $2 a month extra to get them, and they're not guaranteed, and they can't restore my site. Do not rely on anybody other than yourself for your backup files, right? And you need to store them off your hosting. And so I had a tutorial, very popular one actually, for Amazon S3. Well, they changed their interface, and security has changed with that. And so I updated the tutorial for this. So even if you have an Amazon S3 account set up for your backup files, be sure you watch this tutorial and look at the end about it for creating an IAM user for each bucket that you've got. I mean, every individual bucket that you've got, you need a different IAM user for it. Why you want to do versioning, why you want to make sure that your files cannot be tampered with. You know, there's all kinds of things in there that you need to know about. So like I said, even if you've got an Amazon S3 account, go look at it. If you're using something else, Dropbox, Google Drive, or whatever, you may want to switch over to Amazon S3 because of all these extra little happy security features as well. And I hope you saw, and I'm going to go ahead and click over to it, about this is the huge news of the week too. And I've got the screen blown up so you can see everything. I'm going to scroll down. how will the new Chrome ad blocker affect your income? Because this is going to be rolling out probably toward the end of the year, January, somewhere in there. They're trying to give everybody a heads up about this so that they, you know, have time to do whatever they're going to do. Now, if you're working with ad networks, of course, they're going to have to take care of this on their end. Please do let me know what your ad networks are saying to you, because I've got clients all over on different kinds of ad networks, and we need to know what they're going to be doing with this. Now, also in this post is a little tester from Google to see, it's all about user experience. And, you know, I ran a little email out to all my Blog Aid News subscribers saying, hey, y'all jump in and even before the post came out, volunteer to test your sites. Everybody, and thank you so much to everybody who participated in that, nobody's sites have been reviewed yet. This tool is that new. And so there's no way that I saw any way for you to test it on demand, you know, like fetches Google or something like that. There's nothing like that that I saw. So I guess we just have to wait till Google bots crawl our sites and see what it is. I hope you will get in the habit of testing this weekly, at least monthly, to see what's going on, because you need to jump through some hoops if it's bad, okay? So think about that. But there's also a lot, if you haven't read this post yet, I'll give you the whole context of what's going on, who's involved, what's happening with it. There's also another thing in there about, hey, pay us to take away all ads. You know, that's another thing coming. So there's a lot to this, and it's, don't just rely on your ad networks to do this. And I know some of you have affiliate links and different sorts of things. You're not working with ad networks as much. You need to read this. Okay, so big news. Definitely something that you need to get on top of. I'm about done here after doing that tutorial and then this. And then meetings all day. My poor voice, by the end of the day, I'm just about done. Okay, the other big news is WordPress 4.8 is supposed to roll out this week. I believe it's Thursday. That it's going to be rolling out. And so I've been poking around all over it, and just as soon as I finish these UpdraftPlus videos, then that's going to be my next one, because I want to have that ready for you on Thursday with the sneak peek of what's going on. I've got a whole post for you to read more too, so I'm going to go through it kind of quick in the video to show you the big stuff, and then I've got a whole post for you about everything else. Now, they crammed a lot of new stuff into this one in a hurry. You know, we're not going to be the first people to update this when it rolls out on Thursday, right? Because this is not an automatic update. It's a major release. We're going to hold off a bit for this. They put a lot in it, okay, in a very short period of time, and there's a bunch of it that's new. As a matter of fact, they thought they were done. They had the release candidate out. They fixed a whole slew of bugs that were found in it, okay? And now we're on the second release candidate. Get my drift? We're not going to be updating this right away. So just to let you know. But you can get a sneak peek, because there's some really fun things that are in there too. All right. Here's another piece of news. And this is one of those, I'm trying to keep you ahead of the game. And we need to pay attention to what's going on here for our future. It's not something you can change or do anything about right now, but just something for us to watch about, and you heard it here first, kind of thing. Okay, I told you a few weeks ago that the WordPress core people have started having meetings about switching from PHP to JavaScript. That's huge. That's the whole foundation of WordPress, themes, plugins. Everything's on PHP. Everything's going to flip to a new coding language. This is bigger than anything I can imagine telling you about. It's huge. I mean, it's just huge, okay? Well, in these meetings, they're trying to figure out what framework of JavaScript, because there's different ones, okay? I won't get into the techie stuff about it, but just know that there are different kinds of working with JavaScript languages in there. And guess which one they're going to use? So, right now, all the JavaScript that's in WordPress, because plugins and different things use JavaScript now. It's not like it's exclusive or anything. They're using Backbone. That's the framework. They're going to go to React. Here's what's so interesting. Y'all need to listen to me, what I'm trying to tell you here. Read between the lines. Okay. Why are they looking at React? Because it was the one chosen for all the stuff that's already been written in JavaScript on WordPress.com. Calypso, which is the new interface. Gutenberg, which is the new text editor. And Jetpack, which all the stuff is going to start piling into Jetpack. Well, it's already piled into Jetpack, and they're piling even more as the end-all, be-all plugin. Guess who's behind that? Matt Mullenweg, the co-founder of WordPress. He owns Automattic. I mean, this is who owns the whole shebang, right? Matt Mullenweg's behind that. Guess who is the lead developer on WordPress right now? Matt Mullenweg. Y'all hearing me? Put two and two together here in my conversation with Matt. Other things that I've seen, WordPress.org is on track to start looking like WordPress.com. They're starting to look like all the same thing. Okay, that's good and bad for us, for our self-hosted WordPress site owners. It's good in that the core needs to change. All these features, I mean, it's just going to blow up with features that are just delicious and wonderful, and it is the way forward and whatever. But it's bad in that it's going to be too much like WordPress.com. From what I saw with some of the things, I don't know. I mean, we're going to have to wait till this all plays out, but I'm telling you, my little caution lights are going off, because we saw what happened with VaultPress when it merged with the way that WordPress.com is doing things and requires Jetpack now, and the hoo-ha over that. I went through Pressable looking at the hosting that Automattic owns now. I had a look at that, and the onboarding process is strange. Calypso is, I guess if that's all you know, then, you know, if that's what you're used to, maybe, but there are some pretty radical shifts if we're going this direction, guys. And I can't say that some of the stuff I'm very pleased about, other things I'm very pleased about. So, I mean, it's a balancing act. So we're just going to have to see what goes on with this. But what I do know is that Matt Mullenweg has a vision, and this is it playing out, okay? That's all I'm going to say about it. We need to keep our eyes on what's going on and keep pace with it so that we don't get too far behind with all of these changes and maybe kind of get ahead of the curve. And you know, I'll have workshops and tutorials and different things for you on that. Okay, insecure, that's all I'm going to say. Just put two and two together, keep your eye on it. Insecurity tips, the OneLogin service was breached. Now, I asked a bunch of my webmasters and nobody else had heard of this either. I certainly hadn't, and I don't know any clients who are using it. Doesn't matter. The thing that you need to, and the reason I pointed it out to everybody, even though I'm not sure anybody's using it, none of these things, even LastPass, none of them are 100% secure, and you're trusting all your passwords to this thing. Think about that for a second. Okay, it's as secure as anything can be, but it's not. So, 100%. Nothing is 100%. You write it down on a piece of paper and lose that. I mean, come on. There is nothing 100%, okay? But you probably need to go in and rotate your passwords no matter what a couple of times a year. I'm not kidding with you. The security people are telling us every 3 months, ha-ha, we're not going to do that. But for your bank, for your sites, for any other financial things like that, your PayPal accounts, rotate them. Just get in the habit. It's a chore. So what? Keep it where you can get to it easy. I have mine in secure documents. You know, do what you've got to do. I mean, every account I've got, Craigslist, anything. You know, every single account I've got, I don't even know how many pages it is for all my affiliate programs and whatever. It also helps with your contingency plan, especially if you're in business, so that somebody can get to all of your accounts and do what needs to be done with them if you become incapacitated or die. Honestly, these people, especially with your bank, PayPal, all these things, they're even your social media accounts, next to kin means nothing. They're not giving out any information for this stuff. So somebody's got to be able to take care of things. So that's another reason for you to be aware of what's going on with this. Rotate these things once in a while. It, honest to goodness, takes you 30 minutes. It takes you a lot longer than that to recover from a hack. Okay. So it's just a chore. It's, hey, you got to clean the house, take a bath, you know, whatever, wash the dishes, whatever your other chores are, that it just has to get done. You know, that's all there is to it. You'll be thankful that you do. Look at it as a happy thing, a way to take a little break for the day from your other pressing matters, right? The other thing in content marketing tips, this is a guest post on Pro Blogger, and I've seen this several times, actually, and the data keeps bearing this out, that the more you post, you don't necessarily see a great return unless you jump. You know, if you post once a week, twice a week, you're going to see about the same return as if you post three times a week. It just, or even four times a week. Now, when you get into five and over, then you see a jump. So unless you're going to post every day, it's almost not worth it to post more than once or twice a week anyway. But here's what I want you to think about. It's not just posting, just being on this hamster wheel of, I've got to make a post on Wednesday, or whatever your routine is. Oh, my peeps expect that on Wednesday. You know what? If you don't make one on Wednesday, the sky won't fall. Guaranteed, though, most of them will be so busy, they'll never even notice. It's self-imposed. It's in here. You know, what you're doing with this kind of thing, it's very much in your own mind what you're doing with that. So, you know, look, reevaluate. Maybe you're missing a ton of audience because you're always posting on the same day, because you're always having your RSS feed pick up at the same time, because you're always putting stuff on social media at the same time and on the same social media stuff. If you want more eyeballs, you've got to mix it up a little bit. Because you've got all of these people, right? You might want to seriously think about mixing it up. Now, the other thing that I talk about in here, and I've got a link to, is Anna Hoffman of Traffic Generation Cafe, because this is one of her favorite sayings, is, help me share the ish out of this. And she's got the traffic to prove that that works. And I've heard other people, David Couture and other really fine folks, say, David Couture, they only post once a month. They got 12 blog posts a year, and they got traffic out the wazoo. I mean, they have run a whole agency off of that. Here's the thing. Post less, promote more. Promote the crap out of, or as Anna says, it's more polite, promote the ish out of it. I mean, everywhere that you can. Write one blog post and promote like your life depends on it, because, you know, in a way it does. Your financial life does, right? And just promote like crazy. I am guilty of not promoting enough. You know, there's only so many hours in the day, blah, blah, blah. Or not going back and rotating some of my stuff while it's still good, because mine's not evergreen. And so I have a limited amount of time to get more of that out there to you. So I am guilty of it so many hours in the day, and it's hurting my business by not doing it. I post when there's news, like this week, I'm posting every single day this week. Well, I don't do that every week because there's not stuff going on every week, or I'm busy working on client things or whatever, you know. Sometimes you can just post when you feel like it too, you know. So the whole point of reading this is just wrap your mind around doing something a little different with your blog post. And, you know, maybe that will get you more eyeballs. Post at different times. Just shake it up a little bit and see what happens. It may drop a little for a little while, and then it may grow again or whatever. But the main thing is, be willing to try something different. Get off of your hamster wheel. However you're thinking about things, it may truly be self-imposed, and your audience may not feel that way about it at all. So just a little tip to think about shaking things up for yourself. All right, guys, I'm not seeing comments here in Facebook just yet. I think it's a little late. I went a little later tonight. I tried something new. Most people are going to catch this in the replay anyway for tomorrow. Okay, guys, be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel to watch these in replay. Like my Blogate Facebook page to catch me live. And I'll see you online.